We exalt your name, Adonai. We exalt your name, the King of glory. We give you praise. We give you glory. Thank you, Father, this morning that we can come to Mount Zion, that we can approach the throne of grace and mercy with confidence. Thank you this morning, Father, that we are welcome on Mount Zion, in the city of our God, in the mountain of your holiness. Thank you, mighty God, that we can come to the innumerable company of angels. We can come to the church of the firstborn, whose names are written in heaven. We can come to the just souls that have been made perfect on Mount Zion. We can come through Jesus, the mediator of the new covenant. We can come through the blood of sprinkling that has been sprinkled on the mercy seat that speaks a better and a more gracious and a more nobler message than the blood of Abel that demanded vengeance. Thank you, Jesus, that as we have come to the heavenly realms, we come through your blood that speaks mercy that triumphs over judgment. Thank you this morning that we are forgiven of sins, of transgressions, of iniquities, by reason of your death and resurrection. We come, O Lord, by the blood, Father, in the presence, O Lord, of your kingdom, Lord. We come, mighty Father. We come in your glory, in your power, in your majesty. And we honor you this morning, Adonai. We honor you, the great and mighty Jehovah. We honor you, Lord, that the Spirit of the Lord God is upon us, that the Spirit of the Lord God anoints us this morning, that the Spirit of the Lord is here to minister through us, to pray through us. We thank you that your Spirit is here with us, and that, Lord, you are enthroned, Father, and that your kingdom is come, O God, upon the earth through us, Lord, the body of Christ. Thank you that as we have gathered this morning, your kingdom is being expressed in this body, in the name of Jesus. Thank you that your kingdom is within us, and your kingdom is being expressed. Thank you, mighty Father. Let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. We thank you, Lord, for the experience of the heavenly realms in your name, King Jesus. Oh, thank you, mighty Father. Thank you, glorious God. We honor you and we exalt you this morning. We exalt the one who is above all things, the one who is above all thrones, the one who is above all kings, the one who is above all nations, the one who is above every principality, every power, every ruler of darkness, the one who is above spiritual wickedness in high places. We exalt your name this morning. You are worthy of it all. Thank you, Father. You are greater than the greatest. You are bigger than the biggest. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, Abba Father. You are awesome in this place. We give all the thanks and the praise to you. We give all the thanks and the praise. We honor you this morning. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised in the city of our God, in the mountain of his holiness. You are beautiful for all situations. You are the joy of the whole earth. We worship you this morning. We thank you this morning. We magnify your name. Oria baba baba seke telebosia. Masokondolobosia. Regado sokondolobosia. Livrado sokondolobosia. Masokondolobosia. We worship you. We honor you. Malihande lebosia andarabokora basia. Robrado sokondolobosia. Maleke telegadosia. Marokondorobosia andarabosia. Masokondoroboseke telebosia. Uria mama kura basekende lebosia. Mariando robosia rabasia. Masokondo robosia andarabosia. Rekete lebosia andarabokura basia. Livrado sokondo robosia. Blessed be your name forever. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. We honor you this morning. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be magnified. You are worthy, Lord. We lift your name on high in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Good morning again, everyone. In 1 Chronicles 29, 1 Chronicles 29 from verse 10, 1 Chronicles 29 from verse 10, the Bible says, "Blessed, praised, adored, and thanked are you, O Lord God of Israel, the God of our fathers, forever and ever. You are blessed, you are praised, adored, and we thank you, O Lord, our God.
For yours, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory and the majesty. Indeed, everything that is in the heavens and on the earth, yours is the dominion and the kingdom, O Lord, and you exalt yourself as head over all. Let us thank our Father this morning as he is seated upon his throne. Our Father is the Father from whom all fatherhood derives his name. He is the great Father. He is the great Jehovah. He is Yahweh, the self-existent God whom nobody created. Our Father is worthy of all honor this morning. Let's thank him and say, Father, be blessed this morning. Yes, our God, be blessed forever and ever. For yours, O Lord, is the greatness and the power. You are greater than the greatest here on planet earth. You are greater than the greatest in any part of the universe. Yours, O Lord, is the greatness. Yours, O Lord, is the glory. There is no glory greater than your glory, Father. Your kabod, your weight fills all the universe. You are glorious, mighty Father. You are glorious. We honor you this morning, Father. And the victory and the majesty belong to you. You dwell in perpetual victory. Father, you have never lost any battle. We say yours, O Lord, is the victory. Yours, O Lord, is the majesty. There is no king that is more glorious or more majestic than you. We honor the throne of our Father who is seated in heaven. Our Father who art in heaven, yours is the victory. Yours is the majesty. Indeed, everything that is in the heavens and on the earth belongs to you, Father. We honor you. Yours is the dominion, Father. Yours is the dominion. You rule and reign in every dimension, in every realm. Yours is the dominion, Father. We worship you this morning. Yours, O God, is the kingdom. Let your kingdom come, Father God, on earth as it is in heaven. Yours, O Lord. Yours, O Lord, is the kingdom. It is yours, Yahweh. It is your self-existent God. You are exalted as head over all. We honor you this morning. We reverence you this morning. We give you thanks this morning. We give you adoration this morning. Awesome is your name, Adonai. Awesome is your name. Oh, blessed, blessed be the name of the Lord forever. We worship you this morning. Yours is the greatness, Father. And our life, our salvation, Lord, is in your hands. And we thank you. We worship you. We worship you. When we go to Ephesians chapter 2, verse 13, the Bible says, I'm reading Amplified Version. But now, at this very moment in Christ Jesus, you who once were so very far away from God have been brought near by the blood of Christ. For he himself is our peace. He is our Jehovah Shalom, and he is our bond of unity. He has brought us near to God and is united all of us all over the world, both Jews and Gentiles. He has united us into one body and broken down the barrier, the dividing wall of spiritual antagonism between us. He has brought us together. Let's thank Father this morning. The Bible says at this very moment in Christ Jesus, we have been brought near by his blood. We've been brought near to Father God. As we pray this morning, we are not praying to a distant Father. We are not speaking to a distant Father, but we are speaking to a Father who is near to us. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you this morning that by the blood of Jesus Christ, in Christ Jesus, we who were once very far away from your presence have been brought near. Thank you that we are right in your presence, that we've been brought near to you, Lord, that we are not praying to a God who is distant. We are not praying to a Father who is far away from us, but we have been brought near. Thank you, mighty God, that as a body, we are united in Christ Jesus. As we have come in your presence, we are united in Christ Jesus. The power of Christ unites us and brings us together in a bond of unity. As we stand as the body of Christ this morning, thank you, Lord, that Christ indwells us, and we are a part of you, Father, and we are in your presence. We thank you this morning that, Lord, you've abolished all the hostility that was caused by the law and its commandments and its ordinances. In Christ Jesus, you've abolished it. Lord, in himself, you have made us into one new man. Thank you this morning that we are standing in perfect unity by your grace and by your power. Thank you, Lord. We honor you that we are no longer strangers in the kingdom kingdom of heaven. We are not outsiders, but we have full rights of citizenship. Thank you that we are citizens with the fellow saints of God who have gathered here this morning. We are all members of God's household. Thank you, mighty God. We thank you, Father, for this acceptance and this privilege of being a part of your household. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. And the Bible says, we have been built on the foundation of the apostles and the prophets, with Christ Jesus himself being the chief cornerstone. We want to thank Father this morning. We are being built up. Remember all the works of the prophets. Remember all the works of the apostles. They did great works, and we are built on their works, with Christ Jesus being the chief cornerstone. If we are built on their works, then it means we do the works they did. If we are built on their works, then it means we look like them. Because the building is determined by the foundation. How high a building goes is determined by the foundation. You and I this morning, we are built on the foundation of the apostles and the prophets, with Christ Jesus being the chief cornerstone. Therefore, this morning, we are growing up into a spiritual body that hosts the presence of God in power, in his glory. For the apostles and the prophets did great works for the Lord. Because we are built on their foundation, we too, we shall do the great works of the Lord Jesus, and greater works than this shall we do, because we are built on the foundation of the apostles. We've been built up into a spiritual house this morning. Father, we thank you for the solid foundation upon which we are standing this morning. Thank you, mighty God. We exalt your name. We give you glory. We thank you for who we are and for the solid foundation we've been built upon. We cannot be shaken. We cannot be shaken, because we are built on the foundation of the apostles and the prophets, with Christ Jesus being the chief cornerstone. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Let's go to 1 Peter 2:9 and begin to declare over ourselves. 1 Peter 2:9, begin to prophesy and proclaim it this morning, that we are a chosen generation. We are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood. Yes, a consecrated holy nation. Yes, oh, krabashalabasia, a peculiar people. God's special people. We are God's own possession. We are proclaiming the excellences, the wonderful deeds, the virtues and the perfections of him who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. Begin to declare it this morning, child of God. Begin to say it. I am not an ordinary human being. I am part of a chosen generation. Yes, I am part of God's royal priesthood. I am able to bring spiritual sacrifices. Because I am royal priesthood, I bring spiritual sacrifices that are anointed with a kingly anointing. For where the word of a king is, there is power. Whenever I speak, there is power. For I am a royal priesthood. I'm not just a priest, but I'm also a king. Hali Bradosia, I have royalty attached to my priesthood. Where the word of a king is, there is power. I speak in power, and I bring spiritual sacrifices in power. For I am royal priesthood. Yes, I am a consecrated person. I belong to a consecrated nation. I am peculiar. Yes, I'm a special kind. I am a special kind. For God has proclaimed his excellency, his wonders, his virtues and his perfection in me this morning. God has called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. We are a royal priesthood in the mighty name of Jesus. We are not ordinary beings. Father, we thank you for who we are and what you have made us to be. We are grateful this morning. Limbradoso korabasia, mazunderebasia, libaluka sanda. Let the royal priesthood express what God has wired them to express this morning, Father. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord. Rebo bozuva kuza malegadosia, rebo boboso kondolobosia, izavradosu kenenemosi andalaba, limbradoso kondolobo. We worship you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we honor you. We give you praise. We give you adoration. We thank and bless your name. Oh, we worship you in the name of Jesus. When we go to the book of Hebrews, Hebrews chapter 10, this is where our authority comes from. Our authority comes from the fact that God has forgiven us and doesn't remember our sins anymore. Every time Satan comes against us, our authority comes from the fact that we've been declared righteous as if we've never sinned. Bible says in Hebrews 10 verse 17, and their sins and their lawless deeds, their lawless acts, I will remember no more. I will no longer hold their sins against them. Now, where there is absolute forgiveness and complete cancellation of the penalty of these things, there is no longer any offering to be made to atone for sin. Therefore, believers, since we have confidence and full freedom to enter the holy place, to enter the place where God dwells by means of the blood of Jesus, by this new and living way, which he initiated and opened for us through the veil into the Holy of Holies. He initiated this way through his flesh. Since we have a great and wonderful priest who rules over the house of God, let us approach God with a true and sincere heart in unqualified assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled clean from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. What is the Bible saying this morning? Bible is saying when God looks at you, he sees a saint. He doesn't see a sinner. He doesn't remember your lawless deeds. He doesn't remember the iniquities of your bloodline. He doesn't remember the transgressions of your bloodline. He doesn't remember the sin where you've missed the marker. There is absolute complete forgiveness and there is a full 100% cancellation of penalty. When God looks at you, he sees a righteous person. He sees a holy person. And this gives me and you confidence and full freedom this morning to enter the Holy of Holies, the holy place where God dwells by the new and living way, which Christ Jesus has opened for us. Let us approach God this morning with a true and sincere heart in an unqualified assurance of faith. Our hearts have been washed and sprinkled clean from an evil conscience. Your conscience must not speak against your miracle. Your conscience must not speak against your testimony. Your conscience must not speak against the power of God in your life. Your conscience must be silenced this morning. Our bodies have been washed with pure water. Our conscience has been sprinkled cleaner. Begin to approach his presence this morning in full assurance and say, Lord, I've come. Your daughter has come. Your son has come. The one you love has come into the Holy of Holies. I have come. Regado sokorabashaya. Enter his presence. We come. We come into his presence. Livrado sokorabashaya. Begin to come. See your yourself in his presence this morning, in his presence. Come boldly, come boldly, come boldly, come boldly, come boldly. Ragadoso koraba shekele bosia. Come boldly this morning, come boldly this morning. Rebaduda bazuva kasabalagada. Come boldly, come boldly, and receive from the Lord this morning. There is no reason why you can't receive. There is no reason why you can't be blessed. The penalties are cancelled. The penalty's been cancelled. The legal grounds are erased by the blood of the Lamb. Jegadusa vrado sokoro baba. Mazokondolo boriababa. Livrado sokondolo boshaya. Jagadusa bradahanda. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Brethren, the reason I've been leading us in these scriptures is so that we understand our authority in the universe and that there is no reason for us to fear any demon, any Satan, or anything of that nature. But because we have been redeemed by God and given this honorable position, we have a responsibility to ensure that things on earth are not going in a way that has not been ordained by God. You know, in about 2016, I had a dream. In that dream, I saw young people flocking to a concert where they were going to see Beyoncé in the dream. I saw Beyoncé on the stage, but I saw the symbol of Baphomet over her, and I saw symbols of marine spirits over her. And every time she was singing, there was a red mist that was coming off the stage, and it was touching everyone in that show. It was touching every one of them. And as it was touching all of them, you know, evil spirits were entering them. And I saw all these young people coming under bondage. There were many, they were in that place. And then I began to see that after this concert, the people who were under that anointing, that influence of that evil spirit, I began to see them in a river. I saw them, all of them had got into this dark river. The waters were sweeping them. And I saw their dead bodies coming out of the water one by one, young people. I saw the water, it was overflowing. Dead bodies were flowing on it. And as the water was flowing, it came to a point where there was a church building. And I saw the evil water washing them out into the grounds of the church. I saw all of them looking horrific, coming into the grounds of the church. And in that dream, we began to pray. And we asked God to resurrect these children, to bring them out of this bondage that they had died in. We were praying for their resurrection. We were praying one by one. We were bringing them out of that water. And I saw children, young people that I recognized. One of them, I recognized him specifically. He was a praise and worship leader. And I called that young man and I said, see the dream that the Lord has been showing me. And he said, Auntie, I didn't know why God had been asking me to fast. This whole week I've been fasting and praying and I just find myself crying and I don't know why I'm crying. Now, I asked him, I didn't tell him that he was one of the people who had been killed by this spirit. I asked him to pray with me and you know that we should gather other young people to pray. But you know what? For some reason, he kept postponing coming to my house. The next thing, what I heard about him is that he is trending on Twitter for announcing that he is gay and that he's changed his Twitter symbols to the rainbows and all this. And then from that day, he steadily began to do things that are very strange, you know, very, very strange. Now, 2 weeks ago, he posted a video of himself at a Beyonce concert. And what I saw was exactly similar to what I'd had in the dream, you know, in 2016. This is not the first Beyonce concert he's gone to. He's been going to them since 2016. And then yesterday, I saw another young person that I know here in Greater Manchester, again, a young boy at a Beyonce concert, and he has become something that you cannot describe. You know, he's walking around naked. It's horrendous what is happening to him. I just, you know, as I was troubled last night and I said, Lord, where do we start from? I know you showed me this dream and I can see these young people one by one. We're not going to just let them die. As I was praying, I went to sleep about 2 a.m. The Lord showed me a dream. In the dream, I saw myself entering a building, a huge, humongous house, which was like the house of government. In that dream, I saw Rishi Sunak and some of the leaders of our nation. And I began to see the sexual demons that were operating there, the marine spirits. I began to see the evil spirits that are hooking children in this land. And I began to see all of them one by one. And the Lord led me to start to minister to some of the people that were in that house. I just want us to pray this morning. The Bible says in 1 Timothy 2, I exhort therefore that first of all, supplications, prayers, intercession, and giving of thanks be made for all men, for everybody, intercession, for kings and for all that are in authority, that we may lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and honesty. For this is good and acceptable in the sight of our Savior, who will have all men to be saved and to come unto the knowledge of the truth. I want us this morning to take a time to intercede for this nation and all the nations we represent, because what I'm seeing is not just in the UK. It's in Zimbabwe, it's in Nigeria, it's everywhere. It's in Cameroon, everywhere you go. These spirits are moving. I want us to stand in the gap. You know, I'm seeing the bodies of these ones I saw in the dream. I don't want to see more. I want us to plead the blood of Jesus upon our nations and take authority over every evil altar that has been raised through music, through alcohol, through drugs, through dance, whatever evil altars have been raised to host the presence of unclean sexual spirits. Every altar that has been raised, let's begin to pull them down in the name of Jesus. We come against their evil sacrifices. We come against their evil voices that are speaking from evil altars. Every time there's a music show and evil altars are raised and evil sacrifices given and young people are captured, Father, we say no to it. We will not wait until more children are killed.
Masukerebo shakabalabo. Rigado sokondolobo. Zegede de bradosia. Limbragado sokondolobo. Zebraduske balikata. Limbaluga dosia. Imalihandelebosia. Father, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we come against evil altars that have been raised from the parliament, from Downing Street, from every parliamentary house, from every local council assembly, from the mayors in all our cities. Father God, in all the nations, Lord, evil altars raised by our presidents, by our governors, Lord, in the name of Jesus, we plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus as the body of Christ. We stand and we plead the blood. We pull down, Lord, the evil altars, likasuka talabaya, the evil sacrifices, whatever has given, oh God, demonic spirits, legal ground to arrest young men, young women. Lord, we come against it. Ragado sokorobo shandalabosia, masokotorobosia ndalabosia, masokorobo shekelebosia, mazivra dosokorabashaya, limbaluga dosokorobosia, lemakunenene mozia ndalabasia, mazukentelebosia, maroko kokoboria bababa. In the name of Jesus, brethren, I want us to pray that every legal ground that Satan has over the lives of our young people through these concerts, through these Beyonce concerts, Rihanna, all of them, wherever Satan is being given legal ground to steal, to kill and destroy, let us plead the blood of Jesus and remove his grounds. By the blood of Jesus, let's remove the legal ground given to demons, given to Ogun and all sorts of idols. Lord, we come against it by the blood of Jesus, the legal grounds given to Mami Water, given to the marine kingdom through this concert. Father, we plead the blood because this marine spirit the Lord was ministering to me, it's not just working on women, it's working on the men as well. It's leading them into all sorts of things, sexual perversion and wickedness and sex addiction. Father, we are pleading the blood. We remove the legal grounds that have been given to Satan and his agents through this concert. Maroko Sokorabashaya. Malega doso kondolobo, libra doso kondolobo, limbregede debosia, robradosu katalaba, limasi katalabasia, nikandalaba. Children have been stolen from Christian homes. Children have been stolen from the choir. Children have been stolen. Limasukelebasia, ribradosia. Lord, we remove their grounds. We remove their legal ground to steal, to kill, and destroy. We remove it by the blood of Jesus. We apply the blood. We apply the blood all over the nation. We apply the blood. We apply the blood, Lord, in Africa. All the nations we represent in Africa, we apply the blood of Jesus. We remove Satan's legal grounds that have been given to Mami Water. We remove the legal grounds that they have given, Lord, to demonic agendas, to witchcraft and ordinances of wickedness. We remove their legal grounds by the blood of Jesus. Every legal ground they have, Lord, to operate against our society, against our children, Father, we refuse. We say no. Father God, the legal grounds, they are given by our prime ministers, by our presidents. Lord, we say no. We say no. Malika sukatalaba, limbrado sokoraba. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. Let the blood speak in our nations. Let the blood wash away the evil sacrifices that are being sacrificed in this concert. Many of them are sacrificing their sexuality, their purity. They are sacrificing their sexual identity. Lord, in the name of Jesus, as they take, oh God, part in all these orgies and all these things they are doing, Lord, we wash away the evil sacrifice. Father, we plead the blood of Jesus upon every bloodline represented here. Every bloodline represented here. Lord, we chase away the sex demons. We chase them away by the blood of Jesus. Regadosia, the spirit husbands, the spirit wives that they are being given in this concert. Father God, we plead the blood of Jesus and we cut them off. We cut off evil unions. We cut off evil spiritual marriages. We cut them off. Lika sukataya, by the sword of the spirit, we cut them off. We say no in our nation, no to evil spirit marriages. Ima lika sukatalaba, lika sandalabosia. The young men are being given spiritual husbands, and it's changing them on the earth to look like something else. The young women are being given spiritual wives. It is changing them into something else. Father, we say no. We say no. Reke sekeleka, rubadula basia, rumadula maleke, livraduske belekata, limbaluka talabasia. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, we plead the blood. We plead the blood. Let the blood speak, O God, and pull down their evil altars. Let the angels of God be assigned to all our nations. Let the angels, O God, who are in charge of cleansing territories, let them be released, O God, and let them contend with whatever evils are being released, Lord, in our nation through concerts, through music, through drugs, loco rubasia, through clubs. Lord, every evil that is being released, Lord, we release angel armies, rimasukelebasia, all over our nation. Nations, we give permission for the angel armies to come. We give permission. Oh, rika sakatala bosia, mazukendele bosia, rekatula basia. We give permission, Lord, for your angel armies. Let them come, Lord, and silence, oh God, mazukereboshaya. Silence the works of the enemy. Silence the evil forces. Silence, oh God. Let, oh Lord, your grace be released to contend, Lord, with those who are contending with these nations. Imaluka sikarabasia, maro. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we pray for mercy. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Bible says in 1 Timothy chapter 4, but the Holy Spirit explicitly and unmistakably declares that in the latter times, some will turn away from the faith, paying attention instead to deceitful and seductive spirits and doctrines of demons. They will be misled by the hypocrisy of liars whose consciences are seared as with a branding iron, leaving them incapable of ethical functioning. Who forbid marriage and advocate abstaining from certain kinds of food, which God has created to be gratefully shared by those who believe and have a clear knowledge of the truth. I want us to pray this morning that wherever the seducing spirits are seducing young people, young men, young women, seducing even grown men and women, wherever people are being misled by the hypocrisy of lying spirits and their consciences are now seared like with a hot iron, they are now incapable of moral functioning, ethical functioning, they are not capable of understanding what is morally right or morally wrong. Let us pray. Lord, we pray for deliverance in the name of Jesus. Anyone, Lord, who has been seduced, anyone listening to the doctrines of demons, mighty God, we pray, break the spell, break the spell, break the spell in the name of Jesus. Let the spell be broken, let the spell be broken. Lord, where people are turning away from the faith because they are paying attention to doctrines of demons and seducing spirits, we pray this morning, deliver them from the spell, deliver them. Let the veil and the scale be burnt with fire. Let the veil and the scales that are being used to blindfold them catch fire in the name of Jesus. All our young men, our young women, our older men, our older women who are under the spell of the enemy, who have been deceived by doctrines of demons, let the spell be broken. Every time they have listened to liars and their consciences have become seared, Father, we pray, resurrect their conscience, resurrect their conscience. Let them know, Lord, when they do something evil, may their conscience be activated. Where their conscience has died, Father, activate their conscience. Imaluka sekelebosia, rimbrado sokorabasia. Activate their conscience. Restore, Lord, restore moral reasoning, restore moral understanding, restore, oh God, a sense of shame. Restore it, oh God, restore mezekelegadosia. Ikalima sandalabosia. In the mighty name of Jesus, restore, oh God, restore, oh God, in Jesus' mighty name. Oh Lord, we thank you. We honor you. We want to pray in Psalm 24. The Bible says from verse 7, lift up your heads, all you gates. Be lifted up, you ancient doors, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, all ye gates, even lift them up, you everlasting doors, and let the King of glory come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord of the angel armies. He is the King of glory. Let's speak to all the territories we represent here, not just the United Kingdom. Let's speak over Malawi, over Zambia, over Zimbabwe, over South Africa, Botswana,
Botswana, Namibia. Let's speak over Congo. Let's speak over Uganda, Gambia, Tanzania, Rwanda, Burundi. Oh, let's speak over Gabon, Nigeria, Cameroon. Let's begin to speak over all these nations and say, lift up your heads, all you gates. The gates that are guarding these territories, the gates around our nations, all the spiritual gates, we prophesy to you. We say, be lifted up, you gates. Lift up your heads. Be lifted up, you ancient doors, you everlasting doors in London. We command all those gates with the lions all over them. We command you to be lifted in that London. We command you to be lifted. London Bridge, we command your gates to be lifted in the name of Jesus. Be lifted up, you everlasting doors. Let the King of Glory come in. Who is the King of Glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, all you gates of England, of Wales, of Scotland, of Ireland. Lift up your head, you gates of all the territories in Africa. Be ye lifted up, you ancient doors. Let the King of Glory come in. Who is the King of Glory? The Lord of Hosts, the Commander of the angel armies. Let him come in. Let the angel armies come in. Let the angel armies come in. The warring angels, let them come in. Let the King of Glory come in. Let him rule over all creation with his heavenly armies. Let him rule, rule and reign in every nation we are connected to. Rule, O God, with your angel armies. Rule, likasukata, with the rod of your power. Rule, with the rod of your strength. Rule and reign, Lord. Rule and reign. Likasekeleba, lemakurabashaya, mazukatalabarabosia, mazuketelebosia, regadosokoroboshaya, ikaluba suka leka sekelema handa, limahunde lebosika legadasia, rabababababa, legadosia, limbradadada, levradozovrede, rimahunda labosia. In the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. Brethren, you may carry on praying in your own time, but as we round up this morning, I want us to go to Psalm 110. Psalm 110. I can see here a message from Hannah. And Hannah is saying the Beyonce concert in London had red mist, just like what I saw in the dream. And that a lot of people who went there felt very weird and strange. We are just praying this morning for their deliverance in the mighty name of Jesus, that God would deliver. In his mercy, God would deliver. Psalm 110, the Bible says, God the Father, the Lord our Father, says to my Lord, the Messiah, his son, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies a footstool for your feet, subjugating them into complete submission. The Lord will send the scepter of your strength from Zion, saying, rule in the midst of your enemies. Your people will offer themselves willingly to participate in your battle in the day of your power, in the splendor of your holiness. From the womb of the morning, your young men are to you as the dew. The Lord has sworn an oath and will not change his mind. Jesus, you are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek. The Lord is at your right hand. He will crush kings in the day of his wrath. He will execute judgment in overwhelming punishment among the nations. He will fill them with corpses. He will crush the chief men over a broad country. He will drink from the brook by the wayside. Therefore, he will lift up his head triumphantly. I want us to speak the word of God and declare that according to what Father has said to the Lord Jesus, the Messiah, Jesus our Lord, this morning, sit at the right hand of God the Father until you make your enemies a footstool. Let every enemy of Jesus on this earth be subjugated into complete submission. I am talking about the principalities, the powers, the rulers of darkness, the spiritual wickedness in high places, mummy water, marine spirits, witchcraft spirits, demonic agendas, spiritism. Let them become the footstool of Jesus. Let them be subjugated this morning into complete submission in the name of Jesus. The Lord sends his scepter, the symbol of his power, out of Zion this morning. And he says, rule in the midst of your enemies. Father, rule. Rule over your enemies. King Jesus, rule over the enemies of righteousness. Rule over the enemies of perfection. Rule under over the enemies of righteous living. Rule under the enemies of purity in young people, in young men, in young women. Rule over your enemies, oh God. Rule over mommy water in the name of Jesus. And then the Bible says, your people shall be willing in the days of your power. We are willing this morning. Begin to declare and say, Lord, I am willing this morning. This is the day of your power. I am willing to participate in your battle in the name of Jesus. I am willing in this day of your power. I am willing to stand on the Lord who is on the Lord's side. I am willing this morning to stand on the Lord's side. This is the day of your power in the name of Jesus. In the splendor of your holiness, Lord, out of the beauties of holiness, out of the womb of the morning, we volunteer ourselves this morning. This is the day of your power. Let your power flow. Let your power be made manifest. Deliver, Lord. Deliver. Cut the chains. Cut the chains. Rika Sukata. Is there any family here where in their bloodline there is any sexual demons that are ruling? Is there any family here that mommy water has been oppressing? Father, we come against that demonic oppression and we break the chains. We break. Lord, is there any family here where there are spirit husbands and spirit wives? We release the sword of the spirit and we cut off the evil union. We cut it off in the name of Jesus. Father, does anyone have a covenant with a spirit husband, a spirit wife? By the blood of Jesus, we renounce that covenant. By the blood of Jesus, we renounce that covenant. We rakasuva kazabalagada rigadosia. We divorce evil entities from every family represented here. We divorce evil entities, evil spirit husbands, spirit wives, entities of wickedness. We divorce them. We cut them off with the sword of the spirit. Any connection to the marine world, we cut it off by the sword of the spirit. Connections to mommy water are destroyed by fire. Let the fire of God destroy in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, we pray that you release your grace upon our families, upon our bloodlines. Let the blood of Jesus speak. Secure our lineages by the blood of Jesus. Secure our sons and daughters by the blood of Jesus. Secure families, Lord, by the blood of Jesus. And let the fire of the Holy Ghost burn all around us so that, Lord, mommy water cannot enter again. Spirit husbands cannot enter. Spirit wives cannot enter. Let your fire burn. Let your fire burn. We speak your fire in the name of Jesus on any entity that tries to join themselves to your children. Any entity that tries to come near us, we speak your fire. Consuming fire. Holy Ghost fire. Destroy their works in the name of Jesus. Any of them that would try to come near our families, we declare they'll be destroyed by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Safeguard our lineages, oh God. Safeguard our families and those, Lord, that Satan is stealing and killing and destroying. We pray for resurrection power to bring them up, oh God. Raise them up from evil. Raise them up, oh God. The church will not be full of dead bodies of young men and women held in bondage by Satan. We say no. Let the children of God be purified in the name of Jesus to serve God in holiness. For we are a chosen generation, a holy nation, a peculiar people. We've been chosen to show forth the praises of the one who called us into his marvelous light. Lord, let it be so. Let the church be sanctified in the mighty name of Jesus. Shekelebosia, rabosukalala, limbradosokolobo, zimbradosokolobo, shaya mahanda, livradosikayanda. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Oh, we worship you. Rimasikatalabosia. Makora bashekete leba. In Jesus' matchless name we pray. Amen and amen.